Periodic table, determining details of atoms. Objective: to determine the atomic number, atomic mass, and the number of electrons, protons, and neutrons of an atom using the periodic table. The periodic table is a tabular arrangement of all known chemical elements according to their properties. The table gets its name because the arrangement of elements follows regular, repeating periods or cycles. The seven horizontal rows on the table are the periods, and the 18 vertical columns, the groups. The table also tells us the chemical symbol for each element. H for hydrogen, He for helium, C for carbon, and Au for aurum, more commonly known as gold. We can use the table to easily identify the atomic number, atomic mass, and number of protons, neutrons, and electrons found in one atom of an element. The number found either directly above or just above and to the left of the symbol indicates the element's atomic number. For example, hydrogen has an atomic number of 1. Oxygen is 8. And chlorine is 17. Just below the symbol is a second number, this one telling us the element's atomic mass. For example, 1.008 is the atomic mass of hydrogen. 12.011 is carbon's. 15.999 is oxygen's. And 40.078 is calcium's. Using these two numbers, the atomic number and the atomic mass, we can find the number of protons, neutrons, and electrons in an atom. Let's use an atom of carbon as an example. Using the table, we can see that carbon's atomic number is 6 and the atomic mass is 12.011. The atomic number is the number of protons that are found in an atom's nucleus, so we already know that carbon contains 6 protons. Atoms are electrically neutral, meaning positively charged protons will be balanced out by negatively charged electrons. In other words, they'll be equal in number. Because carbon contains 6 protons, those will be balanced by 6 electrons. We now have the number for our protons and our electrons. An atomic mass represents the total number of protons and neutrons inside the nucleus. Carbon's atomic mass is 12.011, which we can round off to an even 12, giving us the mass number. We already know that carbon has 6 protons, meaning the remaining particles will be neutrons. Summary: on the periodic table, elements are arranged according to their atomic numbers and electrons. The horizontal rows in the periodic table are called periods and the vertical columns are called groups. Using the atomic number and atomic mass of an element, we can find the number of protons, neutrons, and electrons in an atom.